modeling. So before going to, actually I want to give a demonstration of some of the software. So last, that we'll do the last 15 minutes, but one of the important topic I want to cover here is, it is already one paper is there in the lecture notes, so that is so-called information technology in water management, scope of internet and web-based water resource modeling. So actually this is a course on soft computing, so I should give a lecture on some aspect of this kind, so realistically soft, since the numerical methods mainly, you know, that this is already developed technique. So here what I will be talking next 15-20 minutes is about the scope of internet and web-based water resource modeling. So you can see that say one term called hydroinformatics is, you can see in literature last few years. So what is hydroinformatics? How we can effectively utilize various available modern technologies available to us with respect to water resource management and environmental management. So in the introduction here, as I mentioned, now the last few years, say up to 1950, computer was not available. So 1950 to 60 or 70, you can see that computer came into picture, and then there is a good boom in computational or numerical modeling, like finite difference modeling, finite element modeling. So if you critically analyze the what happening in the last 30 years, a good big revolution is taking place in the area of information technology. So accordingly, we can change. Now you can see that you can do many things from your office through using your PC or internet or web-based things. So there is a change in traditional planning, modeling and decision-making methodologies in water and environment. Since it is there in every field of engineering, but now since we are discussing water and environment related issues, so I am only specifying water and environment issues. So this, you can see that all of you know, all of you are doing it, all of you are feeling it. So this IT, information technology, plays a major role in sustainable development and management, especially water management. So you know that now everybody is earlier 10 years back, nobody was bothered about email, but now after getting up in the morning and coming to office, first what you are doing is checking your emails. So that is the way our lifestyle has changed. So that is where the information technology play a major role. So similarly, all field of engineering, these changes have been taking place. So what are the changes taking place, and what we can do with respect to this modern technology? So that is what the theme of this paper which I am presenting here. So last few years, so many sophisticated computers and many hardware and software tools are available, and there is a realistic revolution in internet and WWW World Wide Web technologies. So there is of course a change in approach in problem solving, modeling, impact assessment and decision making, etc. So before 1950s, as I mentioned, most of the time we have to go for a physical modeling or field study. So that we generally call it as so called hydraulics. So we either you have to go to field and measure, or you do an experiment in the laboratory and get your data. And then 1950s onwards, you can see, as I mentioned, the numerical methods like finite difference method, finite element method came into picture, and there is a drastic change in our approach. As I mentioned, the laboratory things, people thought that there is no neural laboratory, so people changed to the computational aspects. Then 1950s, 60s, 70s up to 80s, this so called computational hydraulics very much prevalent, and people are looking for developing models, mathematical models. And then most of the problems were used to solve using the computers. So that time we call it as computational hydraulics. So 90s onwards, there is again a change. As you can see, a large number of soft computing tools like artificial neural network, genetic algorithm, genetic programming, then fuzzy logic, all these things came into picture. And then of course a large boom in the area of WWW, World Wide Web technologies. Now whatever you want, you don't have to even say literature review. Nowadays you can ask the PhD students, say during my time or many of your time, we just go to library and then we have to go through each of the hard bound volumes and then see each of the title and see what is there. Otherwise we could, but nowadays our students, what they are doing, they just sit to the computer, there is say there are certain softwares and some say web based systems are available like Science Direct, then Engineering Village, etc. So you just give a search word, you can get everything on your desktop, what is available, and then many of the things, if the institute is allowing or the agencies are allowing, then you can download. So literature review has become so easy. So that is the way things have changed. So that is what I am saying. Hydraulics, there is hydraulics, then computational hydraulics, then hydroinformatics. So now most of the things you can download, you can do through internet, you can do through the web-based system. So that is where this term called hydroinformatics came into picture. So if you just have a look, if you critically analyze what has happened, so what is the, there is now about five generations of models, modeling is concerned. You can see the first generation is solution by hands or calculator, small analytical models. So this is hydraulics and environmental before 1960s. This is the first generation models. And then second generation, as you can see, the numerical methods like finite difference, finite element, etc. came into picture. So their computer is very much essential. It is machine friendly. Techniques like FDM, FEM came into picture, and physical problems we can solve it by using these computers. So these are the development in 1960s and 70s. And then third generation, so actually you can see that in second generation PCs were not available. We have got large systems like in IIT Bombay. We are having a system called Cyber, or even in 60s or even 70s or even beginning of 80s, even IIT Bombay, we do not have large systems. We used to go to BARC or TIFR to get computers. So there are big systems were there. So that was not at all user friendly. It is mainly, so we had to, even data entry was through punching cards. So that was the way it was doing. So here, this was the second generation computers, and third generation, you can see that more powerful computers came, PCs also came into picture, and power computational models, and some packages also came. But these packages were just DOS-based packages. You know now also how difficult it is to use the DOS-based packages. So that was in the beginning of 90s, 1980s. And the fourth generation models, you can see that 90s or end of 1980s, a term called a graphical user interface came into picture, since it was seen that data entry and data manipulation, data or the post-processing, pre-processing was so difficult, even though the model is modeling, that running the model is same, but the post-processing and pre-processing are so difficult. So that is why graphical user interface came into picture. So this was the fourth generation models. So here you can see that it is very user friendly, then a menu driven environment and state of the art commercial software. So this has become the standard tools in industry. So you can see that many software available, like now Abacus, then many finite element method based package, start like that, number of packages are available. So these are the development in 1990s. And now what is going on is so called a fifth generation model. So here the fifth generation model, you can see that you do not have to buy everything, you do not have to install everything, or even now what we are, so this is what is the theme of this paper, the hydroinformatics. So here it is, most of the things are based upon internet and world wide web based technologies. So you don't have to really buy a complete software. So for example, if you are a consultant, you have got a problem, say like just a groundwater modeling or contamination modeling, then you have to buy a software. Really you may have to pay 3 lakhs, 5 lakhs rupees, but say for example, if the agency is allowing you to download this software and put it in your computer, they are not sending anything, only you can directly go to their site and download, and then they give a software pack, a password for 1 week or 2 weeks. So even if you pay 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees to do your work in 2-3 weeks time, then you are saving a lot of money, they are also saving a lot of money. The advantage is that they will be getting a number of clients. So people like us, we cannot buy package 3 lakhs 5 lakhs we cannot spend, but 2,000 3,000 5,000 we can spend. So if 100 people are using this with respect to 5,000 rupees, you can see that the companies will get a large amount of money, and we are only paying very very less money. And moreover, you can see that the software we are getting, we may not use all the time, we may use once in a while. So that way, that advantages are there. So that is why we are now proposing. So this is called within the area called hydroinformatics. Everything is changing, and now everything is based upon internet and world wide web technologies. So here you can see that all the GUI are graphical user interface based system. So fully so that we can do it everything very easily. And then this for all generations, you can see that this is only for specialists. So you should know what is finite difference method, you should know what is finite element method, otherwise you cannot develop a model like this. So that is the difficulty. But now you can see that the new generation models, so actually they will be giving a specified some of the how to do it will be given. So then you can easily start with that, and then without much knowledge of the what is the hardcore technologies, you can still utilize the model. So that is the advantage of this new generation models. So this is for everybody without special knowledge, helpful for decision makers and readily understood. So the decision maker, maybe you are working in a firm, you are an engineer, you know what is what, but the decision maker may be an MBA person or without any knowledge of engineering. So but if you have such package, you can just show him how it is working, very easily he can understand it. So that are the advantage of this new generation model. So this is available everywhere, less cost and more efficient. So that way a revolution has taken place last 5 or 8 years, and this soft computing tools like artificial neural network, genetic algorithm, etc. are very easily implementable in this world wide web or internet based technologies. But of course lot of challenges are there, you cannot just believe everything, you have to do same. And moreover, last 50 years of development, what we have done, that we have to now convert into this kinds of system. So that is another challenge in front of us. So a lot of challenges are there. So hydroinformatics, we can just define it is developing and applying mathematical models and advanced information communication technology to problems of hydraulics, hydrologic and environmental engineering. So flow of information and its knowledgeable application. So this is the fundamental definition of so-called hydroinformatics. So as I already mentioned, so what is happening is everything is computer based decision support system, and we integrate expertise, and then everything is available in GUI, graphical user interface, and then we either use independently or through based upon the internet based technologies or the world wide web technologies. So of course you know that in this artificial intelligence or AI techniques play a major role, and then that is the advantage, and then that is the main theme of this short time course also, as you know. So as I mentioned, this decision support system, that is another important aspect in all these hydroinformatics based models. So even though, so decision support system, we start with the data set, and then it will be going through a number of modeling tools, and then finally what we are getting is we are getting pictorially on the screen of the computer, we can see what is the decision or what scenarios are directly available. So that is the advantage of this so called decision support system. And numerical simulations are subject to constraints, legislation, contracts, agreement, etc. And then expert knowledge and experience, these are very much essential to develop such a decision support system. So the developments, as I mentioned, various development like GIS. Now if I want to say model an area, is like just like a watershed. Now what we can, I will give a small demo of some of the software available. So what you can do, you can just get a topo sheet of the area, and then you can just scan it, and then through GIS, geographic information system, you can just feed to the computer. So you can visualize what is happening and where you are putting your model. We can introduce the river, you can introduce the lake, whatever way it is possible. So that is the advantage of GIS. And then of course artificial neural network or other kinds of techniques are also very much easy to apply this. And then some of the major projects sponsored by World Bank, then sponsored by UNESCO, etc., like Venice protection work in Italy, then flood protection, flood action plan in Bangladesh. So all these things, this has given very important development in hydroinformatics. So here you can see that many of these projects, not all these the experts did not come to the place where the project is executing, but they contributed from different parts of the world through internet and through World Wide Web technologies. So that was given a very important developments in the area of hydroinformatics. So you can see here this some of these things are not so clear, but you can see in your lecture notes also. So in a typical hydroinformatics system, you can see that many people will be coming together. That means if you want to solve a large kinds of problem, like say for example our Narmada river planning and development, or river starting from river planning, river development, and then dam construction, canal system, etc. So you can see see that is a very large project, maybe to the tune of 5,000 crores of rupees or 1,000 crores of rupees depending upon the project. So there, a number of people have to come. It is not only engineers. There will be accountants, there will be managers, there will be scientists, there will be the legal experts, since so many issues we have to sort out. So then operators, so many of the things which we have to deal is that what is the real system, like hardcore engineering, what is happening, then rainfall runoff, then geotechnical aspects, then found the structural aspects of the dam, then of course the legal framework, then of course the economical aspects, whether we have to generate money from the market or whether we have to get funding from the organization like World Bank, or say which way we have to go, and then of course the environmental issues we have to deal, and then also we have to deal the social aspects. So it is so many people have to come together to deal with such a large project. So that is where the advantage of this hydro informatics system. So to call all these people to the place and then to do the project is very difficult. So that is why if they can contribute through the systems like World Wide Web or through the internet based system, then that will be very useful. So let us consider a simple system like the urban sewage and drainage project, say for example city of Mumbai. So the information necessary are, we need a sewage and stormwater produce network, what is existing network, catchment and what are the development all taken place and performance of the network, then human dimension like historical, sociological, legal, economical, management, political, etc. So many issues we have to sort out, and then as Professor Ipira mentioned here, there is so many slums there, so to put even a drainage, it is not so easy. So these legal issues, political issues, sociological issues, all these things we have to consider. So most information depends upon the geography, and then depends upon the, it is time dependent, so we should use to such a project geography information system is very useful. We have to put many of this aspect into a GIS system so that we can have efficient modeling, and then database and documents we have to prepare, and then we have to generate the future scenario and generate data, and then if there is a decision support, that means if this is the way, if the drainage is going this way, how effective it will be, so that the decision support, the managers or the municipal commissioner can take an easy decision. So, and then we have to also communicate this decision at all level. So in the hydro informatics system, here you can see how it is possible. You can have a system like say considering all the aspects, say if you are using either physically based model, and then decision support and negotiation, data driven modeling, archiving, analysis, information knowledge acquisition, then feedback and control. So this is not only one way traffic, but you have to, many times we have to come back, and then we have to go through the various systems. So that is the way we have to develop such a system. So we need to develop an information management system like this under the hydro informatics system. So this is, even though this is a sewage drainage but a city like Mumbai, it is a very complex process, but so we have to consider so many aspects, and then many issues like if remote sensing data is available, that will be very useful. If GIS package we can put, that will be very useful. Of course numerical modeling is required, and this is only our engineering problems, but then you have to see the legal issues, the sociological issues, then if any flooding takes place, what can happen. So the future scenario also you have to analyze. So this is all these things can come together under the umbrella of hydro informatics information management, and then the modeling will be very useful. So that is why now we are instead of now you can see that number of companies are operating at different levels, but to do a project, a particular project, we can constitute a company called a virtual company or virtual institute. So that company will be dealing only that project for the duration of that project. So it is not a realistic company, it is a virtual company, and people from different companies are working for this particular project for the virtual company or virtual institute. So in the hydro informatics, to have such a company or such an institute, we need an object oriented paradigm, and then working process we have to sort it out, and then we can utilize if such a company is formed. As I mentioned, no need to come all these experts to a particular location, they can work from their areas, and then they can contribute through the WWW or World Wide Web based systems and internet based system. So the experts at different locations merge for the time of the project, duration, into joint virtual institute or company, and the cooperation of experts are happening through internet and worldwide web platforms. This is what we are doing in a virtual company or virtual institute. So this is for the project duration for that particular project, and many experts are coming together and working together, and this working is happening through worldwide web or platforms and through the internet. So that is what the concept behind the virtual institute or virtual company. So you know that to deal such projects, like as I mentioned, the Narmada River project or your interlinking river project, or this a large scale hydro engineering environmental projects include wide range of scientific disciplines. So and a group of experts can come together and working groups can be formed. So single project groups in many enterprises, that is what is happening. Project is single and our objectives are also unique, and but many people are coming together, and but they are not physically coming together, they are working from their places only, but there will be a common platform, common one system will be there which will be controlling all these things, and one person will be there who is project provider and project manager. So in a typical virtual company or virtual institute, the project structure will be like this. We are having a project provider, and then there will be a number of softwares will be used, so that is so called software provider, and number of experts will be there, so expertise provider. Then data provider, you have seen that a large set of data we need for any of these projects, so data provider will be there. Then budget provider, who finance, like agencies like World Bank or Asian Development Bank. And then constraint provider, so who controls this, this should be the way, that should be the way, like our environment ministry, they are putting so lot of constraints, any kind of development. So you can see that how it is, the there can be a constraint provider. And then task provider, so even they are dividing each task, how, and then of course there will be milestones, you have to achieve certain milestones, and most of the projects you can see that it is time dependent, so whether we are achieving 3 months time, 6 months time, what we should achieve, whether that is happening. So task provider, so this is a typical project structure in this in a virtual company or virtual institute. So as I mentioned, the project provider gives the budget, task, constraints, etc., and expert provider gives software, then construct model, operate and analyze the results, and data source gives data, necessary data, and all the providers can use their own subcontractors, there is no problem. And then finally all the providers form a virtual institute or company during the project duration for that particular project. So the hydroinformatic projects, so here you can see the a lot of changes are needed. So all the phase, generally we put it in a printed sheet or just in CDs, but here the present phase in the hydroinformatics virtual company, we need data transfer are transferred over the net, we are, so that we need Windows or Linux based systems. And then future transfer, maybe again this drastic change may take place, this is, there will be data action and methods, so that once you transfer this thing immediately, what is the action required, that will be also specified, and how the system will be. So the operating system, so earlier now we are using just a computer, the Windows as operating system, now the our operating system will not be, we of course in Windows, but effectively the operating system will be the internet, and the user interface will be World Wide Web browser. So it can be, you know, that Mozilla or our Microsoft Internet Explorer or whatever it is. So the user interface in this kinds of modeling is IIW browser. So this is very important. The operating system is internet, and the user interface is IIW based browser. So now due to this, we need platform independent objects. So that is very important, since say if you do in Fortran or if you do in C or what kind of language, that should be obtained through the internet, and that should be available through the, that should be used in worldwide web browser. So that is important. So separation of data models and algorithm methods we have to overcome. So you can see that what is happening. So this is user environment and this is provider. So what was there yesterday? So there is a software engine and then Unix type system or Windows based system. And now what is today is, we can see that Windows or Unix based system, there is an X server, and then even data plus action. And then tomorrow, that means everything is in the IIW based systems and internet based system, you can see that everything is data plus method plus action is happening together. And then this is the way the system for the tomorrow. So now earlier we called workstation, now we can call it as X station, and now the next generation is so called net station. So finally, you can, here I have listed what are the possible components in such a company. So there will be definitely a project engineer, and then there is a cooperation base, software base, document base, knowledge base, information base. Then these people will be giving software provider, expertise provider, data provider. So all these things coming together, and then that will be connected together, and there may be a server which will be controlling everything, and then different people can access to this server through their internet and WWW browser, and then they can work, they can contribute together. That means, depending upon the, of course, if data is not available, we cannot run the model, but whatever we can have a sequential way of approach, and then we can put that so that the project engineer can control this in an effective way. So finally, what is happening is, of course, the person who is not contributing particularly, things are not allowed to enter, so there should be controlled access is very important in this kinds of system, and a business and training process should be supported by WWW based platform. And then it was seen that this our normal kind of language is not so good, so Java is found to be very good, and a lot of development is taking place in Java technology, and now latest techniques are also available other than Java. So this can be the advantage is that if you use Java type based technologies, it can be downloaded system independently, and this includes innovative multimedia presentations and all those things, and then there will be an editor. So there's various software components in such an integrated system, includes the model editor, the model manager, model reporter, information base will be there, database will be there, and model process will be there, and everything will be connected through the internet, and those who are contributing in that, they can directly access through the internet all these various databases, which may be put in a single computer, and then that computer will be connected to various other computers also. So finally, say when we deal with the software design and components in WWW environments, the components are isolated and encapsulated in independent components and distributed, and a project engineer, he has got more flexibility to compose it himself, specific systems for specific projects by selected components, and we can exchange information between components, and then a reported document modeling process can be there, and then of course everything is interactive, dynamically interactive through WWW documents in the internet. So that is the way we can design software components for this type of modeling. And design techniques are concerned. Design is, of course, it should be object-oriented approach. See, so we have to use either C++ or Java or that kind of language. So object-oriented approach should be there. The advantage is that we can integrate data and methods on the same level as attributes of encapsulated objects. And then generalized classes with high encapsulated functionality, the system will be much more accessible. And then there will be software system is transparent and less complex and easy to handle. So these are the way we can design such a system. And software implementation is concerned, as I mentioned, there is Java is one of the very important software we can use for these kinds of purposes, since it is platform independent. And then you can, even if you are using Windows 98, Windows XP or any kind of things, or even Linux, this Java will work, it seems Java will work. And then new languages like ActiveX is also available nowadays, so that may be a better way of using for these kinds of systems. So before winding up this this lecture on Professor internet or web based system, I'll just give a demo of a case study, which was typically say a number of people came together, and then some work, these kinds of environment related work was done. The case study is the Virchow Institute is named as Morwin, and it was there in Germany. So this is to model the morphodynamics of Baltic Sea. You see that Baltic Sea is a very, say, large sea, and then you can see that the coastal area, what is happening, coastal hydrodynamics, what is happening, and then how is the erosion taking place. So many things have to be done for a large area. So then many institutes came together, and then they were working from their own place, case, and then they contributed. So that is as a typical case, we generally project as a virtual company or virtual institute, so-called Morwin in Germany. So the research projects are supported by German Research Foundation, DFG, and then German Ministry, and then various universities, University of Cottbus, Darmstadt, Hanover, Federal Waterway Administration, and then University of Riga, Latvia, all these universities came together. And objectives was morphodynamic simulation on German Baltic coast and experimentation of long distance cooperation on internet based platform. That was the aim of the project. So here you can see this is the Morwin, and then there will be a particular server, called Morwin will be there, and that will be connected to different servers at University of Hanover, University of Darmstadt, University of Cottbus, and University of Riga, and then Waterway Authority in Germany. So different agencies, there will be a particular server will be there, and that server is connected to various other contributing agencies servers, so that all the people can contribute. So here the main aim was numerical modeling of the morphodynamic processes, that means including the erosion, then coastal hydrodynamics, then the sedimentation, all those things were there in the particular modeling. So the project composed experts for physical and numerical modeling, then software and net engineering models, modeling, and breakdown of tasks according to specialist of workers. Working groups were formed for information based grid generation, visualization, numerical models, physical analysis, data collection, etc. So distributed composition of working groups came together to form the virtual institute. So virtual institute is the project provider as well as software and expert provider at the same time. So internally defined working groups deals with the different tasks. I'm going slightly in a faster way, since I would like to give you a 10 minutes demo of the software also, so that is why. But all these details are there in the lecture notes. So here the data is collected by Federal Bureau of Waterways, Germany, and budget were given by German Federal Ministry. Project control steering committee, head of institutions of this, all the universities and research organizations. And here they want to have to project this as a typical system, so that is why the organization structure was very low. There is room for individual initiatives. If you want to do add something more, there are possibilities, and experiments with existing WWW tools and development of new concept, that were what they checked. Actually, this project started in 1998, and then it went through 2004 or 2005. So the working process in the virtual institute is based on the distributed net based project platform and internet and WWW operating systems. Core of the platform is two WWW servers and internet Morwin server as cooperation and working platform, and there is no open access, only direct access is only to the experts. And external Morwin, there is two component. One is internal server, there is, everybody cannot access to that, only those who are the head of the divisions or the people who are directly controlling. And there is an external server where all the public presentations are put, so people can check it, and what is going on they can check, all the people can access this. So there are a few virtual file systems shared over the internet. So this shows the typical Morwin projects with this thing. So this here, there is a local nest connected to internet, and then information base, separate PC, file system, then tool base, documentation base, etc. So here there are the shared file system, and then the bases are specially distributed over the net, and the bases are installed at different locations of the project partners, and local elements are linked over the internet using WWW system and internet based communications also. So since you see that even the one file is there, that may have to be shared by different people even the same time, so there it has to be made through distributed shared file system, so that that way they have developed it. And then common shared file system, some of those things, since different agencies may have to work together. And then there are TCP IP protocols, so that anybody can communicate between other computers as well as the person through the internet. So in there is an intranet, that means you know the difference between intranet and internet. The intranet is only of specified systems, internet is common to everybody. So intranet, a shared file system based on NFS based network file system is installed, and then each intranet a specific login password is given, allocated for the different people. And as I mentioned, some of the things are open only for project members, and some of those things are open to everybody. So that way the system has been developed. So here you can see that design and build up has been done in three steps. First step is collect necessary and useful data from data provider, and then second step is data files are analyzed and integrated in one file based management system, and third step is existing data are modeled and transformed into standardized structure. So software tools are the information base and data and methods, and then what are the developments also people can put it through there are option for that, and tool base gives the program tool base, the new object oriented tools have been developed for this particular system. So this shows the integration of information tool and documentation base. So here we are having a documentation base, then tool base is there, then information base is there. So here they use the Java, as I mentioned, Java applet has been used for various purposes. So this shows some of the visualization and gridding done for this particular thing. And the traditional documents, like say you can see that whenever we want to see that, say traditionally we send email or we can just send through paper, but here everything is, there are whiteboards, then there is particular one set of computer is kept only for this purpose. So if you want to put some messages, there is a message board in the computer itself, you can put it and others can read it. So like that, everything is through the internet and WWW based systems. So these are some of the network file transmission, as I mentioned, through HTML, and then conferencing possibilities are there, then model information, data analysis, model editing. So all these processes are possible one by, say, for the given system. So WWW based software system developed and installed in server at Codeboost. Codeboost was the controlling agency here, University of Codeboost, and performance tested a pilot study through they used, at that time you see that this is 1999, so they have used a Pentium system, and the performance was found to be satisfactory. And of course this depends upon the data transfer, depends upon the speed of the networking. And the user interface of model manager offers access to existing and new projects, and model editor provides user interface instruments for editing the model objects. And for editing process, objects are transferred via internet, and controlling and monitoring is done through instruments enabling engineers to control and monitoring the simulation process. And WWW report include applets, and engineer can use these interactive applets for data analysis and reporting. So reporting is innovative, dynamic, no more passive and static. That means what you are doing immediately visible for the other people. So it is very much dynamic. So finally, to conclude, this was a typical case study which is still available in the internet. You can just, if you give a search about Morvin, all the details are available. But due to lack of time, I could not explain everything. So to conclude this lecture, so you can see that there is the lot of revolution taking place in the information technology, like World Wide Web systems and internet techniques. So the IT advances in the last three decades. So we are now having the term called hydroinformatics. So hydroinformatics is, say, from the computer hydraulics, now we are going to the hydroinformatics, so where all the software tools we can directly utilize. You don't have to pay for, you buy a complete software as such, but you can utilize the software by paying a small amount, and then now everything is WWW based project platform in this hydroinformatics. And then you can see the concept of virtual institute or virtual company. So a group of, say, heterogeneous people at different locations collaborate together in a project, make models, data collection, and execute the project to success. And experts work together through the internet and WWW based technology, and so that way we are having a new way of collaborative engineering in a distributed environment. So as I mentioned, various types of people, managers, accountants, engineers, scientists, then environmentists, all these people are coming together for the success of the project. So engineer become independent of the local facilities, so you don't have to worry, I don't have this software. Even you can utilize the supercomputer in US from here. So that is advantage of such kind of system. So internet become the computer and WWW the operating system. So even though of course you need a computer, but what I am saying is, what is really happening is that everything is passing through the internet. So internet is becoming the computer, and WWW World Wide Web browser become the operating system. So there will be new options for developing countries like India, we are, as I mentioned, to buy a software, very sophisticated software, we need 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs, even DHA software, Mac 21, the cost is about 20 lakhs. So it is impossible for us to get such software. So, but if they allow us to utilize their software for maybe few days by paying a small amount, so that way we are having lot of advantage in this kinds of way of modeling. So we are having cheaper technologies, project cost saving, and availability of variety of experts from all world, and the project execution less time, and of course there will be more efficiency, but there will be a lot of challenges. So there is a lot of scope for we can do contribute through research, various how we can make it a very efficient hydro informatics system for these kinds of triple W based or internet based system. So a lot of challenges are there in front of you. So if you have got any few one or two questions, we can discuss. Such a large-scale project we have not done so far. As I mentioned, such a collaborative project in India we have not done. But of course, the theme of this is of large-scale project can be done. But when we are utilizing, say for example, some of the software which I am going to demo, you just now there is option. Say they will give us a password for 2 weeks. Then you can. That is small scale. But a large scale like a big projects, so far it was not coming to pick, not done in India. But one of the project which was done in Bangladesh for this flood estimation, since that was supported by World Bank and UNESCO, so they got all these experts together and their detailed study was been done for the Bangladesh flooding, but not in India so far, in my knowledge.
In hydro informatics information system, under decision,
of course, decision support system is an integral part of such project. So, decision support system. What is decision support system? We start with some database, and then of course we are using some software, and finally graphically we are putting say this is to be done, that is to be done, which way. That is a decision support system. If and buts questions will be coming, and then different scenarios are created. So, DSS is very important aspect in hydro informatics, as I mentioned. So, most of these projects, of course, DSS is also there, integrated within the system. Any other questions?